So this is what I've done. You notice here that I had to add a new div with a container class. This makes sure that the margins on the side of the screen look good. Then inside of the container, we have our row, and then finally the columns inside the row. Scrolling down, we can see that each row has a total of 12 columns. So for instance, this row with featured work has column medium 12, while the row below featured work contains two columns, each one of class column medium 6. Notice how we have multiple rows on the page. For instance, we have a row here for featured work, and inside the row we have column medium 12 because featured work takes up the entire width of the screen. However, in the row that contains our two samples of work, we have two columns, each of size 6. 6 plus 6 is 12. So these two take up the entire row. Coming back to our question, we did need to add a container div outside of our rows. So that one is true. We didn't need to add any new divs to organize columns and rows. That was already done for us. Inside of our rows, we did need to add new divs with columns to organize our content. So this last one is also true. If you want to see the full solution, check the link in the instructor's notes.